It is mail day here at Paper and Moose, but it is also actually storage unit in a box day. Our friend Richard, that is a frequent watcher and commenter on the channel, has sent me pretty much a storage unit in a box. So join me as I go through and see what Richard found in a storage unit that he sent to me. I think this should be really interesting. I've never purchased a storage unit. I would love to. Perhaps this summer, if they open. I don't know if they will. But if not, hey, a storage unit has been sent to me. So Richard said to open up this tin first. So we should do that. It says Disney Christmas Collection. Ooh. Disney Christmas Past. Open the enclosed collectibles display. Write a message and address on card. Fold an enclosed card in clear mailing pouch. Place in mailbox. Place first class postage on outside of the mailing pouch. Oh, you can open it. Okay, good. I was like, that's weird. Disney Christmas Past. Oh, look how nice that is. It's Mickey and Pluto. This is from 1993. A lovely, really cute Disney ornament. These are nice. I have never ventured to Disney during Christmas. I would love to, if only to see the decorations. I know that Christmas time there is insane, but I think I would still like it. Something a bit different than New Jersey weather Christmas. And speaking of Disney, we have some more. Oh, I see even more. We have an Eeyore. For these pajama bottoms, that's what it looks like. You gotta love Eeyore. Do not disturb. Too bad I can't wear those motorcycle to work. And this is the top too. Eeyore is fun to meet at Disney. You can meet him, well, at the Winnie the Pooh ride or at the Crystal Palace. Oh my gosh, there's a whole bunch of stuff in here. Ooh, I can wear these the next time I do go to Disney. These are cute. It's so crazy, all the different mouse ears that they have. It's unbelievable. Those are fun. Should I put them on? How do they look? I don't have to worry about them messing up my hair because you know my hair situation. What is this? Pictures found in Disney unit. Some of Disney. Oh my gosh, this is good. What's that, Disney soap? It is very odd, but people can be very crazy about this stuff. I always stay at Pop Century, and they had a special, each resort kind of has a special scent. And to save money, Disney has taken out putting individual soaps in the rooms, and now it's installed. You know, the shampoo, conditioner, and body wash are installed in this device in the shower, so you can't take them. Now, if you really wanted to, I'm not saying I have, I've just thought of this, you could always just bring your own empty bottle and, like, just fill it up. This is fun. There's a whole bunch. Disney bath soap, the Disney resorts, it says on the back. Yeah, if you ever do go to Disney, each resort has its own scent, and it is amazing. These must be a little bit older. Those are fun. Then we have some magic towels. I wonder what this, that must have been fun doing a Disney locker. Oh my gosh. Disney cards, Disney pins, 102 Dalmatians. I have not seen that one. And then there are actually some Disney. Oh, this is from Christmas. 2002. And some of the characters. Oh, this is Disneyland. This is the Small World in Disneyland. When I was in Disneyland 2 years ago, I was there for one day. I was out in California for work. They actually still hadn't taken down the Christmas for some of the rides, and so I was able to see Small World in the Christmas, which was fun. I'd love to go back to Disneyland again. That'd be really cool. But we shall see what happens. Ooh, these are cute. Ooh. You have Cinderella. These people really love Disney. And Snow White stickers. Those are fun. Then we have, I remember these. Or I've seen these before. Handmade Garland. This is $12.50. This guy is a little cutie. With the snowman. These are great. These take a lot of talent, more talent sewing than I have, that's for sure. Ooh, a Disney bag. Perfect. You can use this for shopping at the grocery store, or even this would probably be good for the flea market as well. Mr. Crow, a whole bunch. A sock monkey bunny. Sock monkeys became popular again. They were popular when I was little in the 80s, and then it started back up. There's a whole bunch of stuff. A whole bunch of pins. Looks like there's a necklace in there. Carpenter Scholarship Tournament. It must be fun buying a locker, because that is really a treasure hunt, but also it is a lot of work, because you have to have General South Carpenters, because you do have to have the means to move the items, store the items, and get rid of the items, because you cannot leave anything there. What is this? A moose magnet. This little guy. I've actually seen larger, not full size, but bigger wooden little deer, moose creatures like that. Another little teddy bear. It's like storage unit, Christmas, and a box. Little birdie. Let's see, mark that. This is something I think you'd find at like Hobby Lobby or Target. He has his little beanie on. That's cute. This is more, oh, it's the 12 Days of Christmas. They are ornaments. Those are nice. This would be good to do something with a craft with. I still have to make a junk journal. We have more little bears. Oh, this is filled. We have a Santa box, a bedazzled one. Oh, wow. Oh, look how cute this is. This is a hair clip. That's fun. But it's all Santa. I've never seen one like that. We have Sleepy, which I am all the time. Another nice vintage Christmas pin. We have some more challenge coin. Oh, wow. Huh. Those are interesting. You usually get those, yeah, in the military. Let's open that up and see what it is. This is for a sheriff. Oh, wow. A sheriff's office in Yolo County. That's nice. We have some more Christmas pins, it looks like, with a note. He said this was a large Christmas storage locker found in jewelry case and unit. Oh, and there's a moose. How fun. That looks like it's a tie tack. Or for a button, if you can see that. There's a whole bunch of pins, just an assortment. Oh, there was even a little leprechaun one. We'll show that guy. He's fun. You can see him. He's cute. Yeah. I can't even imagine how long it probably took you to go through everything. We have a moose, Christmas moose. Oh, this is not what I expected in there. These are coasters. I thought it was gonna be candle. Those are cute. Those would be good for a party, either for Christmas or even for like a little kid's party. This says candy. Oh my gosh, they're bottle brush trees. These are the modern ones, but still, can never get enough. These are just really great accents to use in all of your decor. Honestly, if you find them somewhere cheap, whether they're the newer or the older ones, just buy yourself a few and see how much fun you can have with them in your decor. Ooh, Disney fabric. I might have to pass this along to someone who knows how to make masks, because these would be great. Because if you have to wear a mask, might as well make it fun. So we have Mickey, and then you also have good old Tinkerbell. And it looks like we have some vintage, I think it's a tablecloth. This looks like the classic snowman bow mold that you might see. He has a similar face. Oh, a Walt Disney Store Donald Duck bag. This is definitely an older one. And I know down, even in downtown Disney or Disney Springs now, they are using, they're selling reusable bags, or they were. Kenny G Christmas album. Green sleeves, little drummer boy. You can listen to Christmas music year round, and I do. There's something fun, and we'll save that for later. Ooh. I'm gonna guess this is a bell. There's something in there I have never come across, so we're gonna save that. Ooh, this is a nice Christmas ceramic bell. This will probably look good by my fake fireplace. That's cute. Another Christmas tablecloth, I believe, with some snowflakes. I'm all set for Christmas. I'll be here before you know it. We have some more ornaments. These are like the thick cardboard, or they're actually tags. I was wrong. And also, another great tip, if you are at yard sales or estate sales, you know, it's much, these are nice. These are like the repro Victorian ones. If you do come across gift tags, wrapping paper, you should just buy it, because it's definitely going to be cheaper than at the store. Except for perhaps the dollar store. But still definitely cheaper. An ashtray. Label on bottom. Look to be high quality. Oh, it's Villeroy and Bach. Those, oh, it's cats. That's so cute. Oh. Yes, Villeroy and Bach, they are a very good name. The auctions that I go to usually do have an assortment of this type of, you know, dish or whatever they put out. And when they do have that come up to the auction block, it is highly bidded. But this little cat is so cute. My porch kitty, she was just around again a couple days ago. She comes over, I give her some treats, I pet her belly, and then she's on her way. But that's really cute. I'm gonna keep that. Cute little dish. All right, I'll show you. Oh, here's a cat pin. It's a patch. Sew it, stick it, do something with it. That little black cat. All right, these are really cool. I have never seen anything like this before. Christmas unit locker, very old Sears vintage Winnie the Pooh light set. I've never seen these, but how? Can you imagine if you're a little kid and these are in your room? I mean, I would not plug these in now, but how cool are they? These are really nice. Thank you so much, Richard. I've never seen anything like this. I don't know if I see the year on it. It says $5.49 on the side. They're from Sears. They're really cute. Then we have some Halloween, vintage Halloween lawn ornaments, 1990. So, yeah, I guess they are vintage. Vintage would be 20 years, and it has to be at least 20 years to be vintage. That's what most people think. And then antique is at least 100 years old. Some people do have, you know, they don't consider 1990s vintage, but it actually is. These are fun. Look at those. You have the cat and the pumpkin, a ghost. These are really cute. And then you can put lights through there. They just don't make these kind of, even these are from the 90s, but they're still pretty cool. Here's the haunted house. You know, now everything is those blow up things. And I don't think in 20, 30, 40 years, there's gonna be a demand for those blow up lawn decor. Maybe I'm totally wrong, I don't know. But because essentially they're made of fabric that can easily rip, how many are going to be kept, which could actually make them collectible later on. I just don't know. Oh, I'm not sure if there's going to be an appeal or not. I'll have to wait and see. It says Christmas. You said you liked, this is a Christmas locker. Oh, look how cute they are. A little raccoon. A little raccoon visited my place the other night and took a little bag of garbage and just had a field day with it. And a jar of peanut butter. A little squirrely. Or a chipmunk. And then we have some birds. Maybe if I put these out, my birds that are here, I think they're real birds. Probably not. I think they're smarter than that. That's cute. That's heavy too, actually. Blast. Oh, that's neat. We have a window Santa and Mrs. Santa. There's Mickey. Oh, I don't want to look in this because if there's like Alice, I'm going to have wanted it. Lizzie McGuire. These are old. Those are fun. And then last but not least, we have the Night Before Christmas picture book. How great is this? The reindeer. Oh, there's even some advertising for cigarettes. I mean, cigars. And then Pilgrimage to the Grave of Clement Clark Moore. And Santa. Wow. It's like I had a storage locker. That was really fun. Thank you so much, Richard, for everything and for all of your hard work putting things together, going through the unit, and cleaning up. You found some really, really cool things that you have sent me and that I will enjoy. And that I can reuse the Disney fabric. Gotta find myself a seamstress to make me a mask. Then I will have a lot more to add to my Christmas decor. So thank you again, Richard. It is much appreciated. So that wraps it up for this mail video. I will have other mail videos coming out with a collection of different mail from all over the United States and the world of people, things that people have sent me from the United States and around the world. It's been a long day, and that bird agrees. So thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you all next time.